east of Omaha. You can listen to the engine moaning out his one note song. You can think about the woman or the girl you knew the night before. But your thoughts will soon be wandering the way they always do when you're riding 16 hours and there's nothing much to do. And you don't feel much like riding, you just wish the trip was through. See, here I am on the road again. There I am up on the stage. Here I go playing star again. There I go, turn the page.
Man, you are one pathetic loser.
Thirty miles west of Birmingham, Alabama, sits a small community mall named after the town in which it resides, Jasper. The mall opened on August 8, 1981, and it is approximately 350,000 square feet. It opened with one anchor and about 10 small stores. The mall would have a prolonged success period and would even defy the odds into the 2000s as current owners at the time, the Sharp Group, would add a major expansion, I'm talking major, with Belk, Kmart, and a JCPenney, which if you think about it is pretty crazy considering where the Kmart franchise was at the time in 2002. But then, like a broken record, the mall would experience a slow decline in stores, and in the winter of 2019, our retail savant, the slumlord millionaire himself, Mike Cohan, which, by the way, is not even his real name, would swoop in like a vulture hovering prey on the highway and would buy Jasper Mall. A year later, however, a local filmmaker would decide to tell the story of Jasper Mall and insert some life into it. Think like what I do, but with a lot more money and a film crew. Netflix released the documentary in early 2020, and it was eerily similar to what us mall enthusiasts do, but actually centered around a janitor that cared for the mall that was definitely a long-lost cousin of the Tiger King. If you know, you know. Having said that, though, it is a great indie flick, and I highly recommend checking it out. It's on Netflix right now. The pandemic, along with the closure of Kmart and JCPenney, has really put Jasper Mall in a dire situation. Add in the fact of having a worthless owner who is more concerned with tax write-offs and broken promises than knowing what is good for a mall, and I think we all know the end result. But for the time being, the domino players and mall workers will inhabit this space and have their communal gatherings, and I suppose as long as Bath & Body Works and GNC keep afloat, the mall will survive. for now. Jasper Mall is a great little mall in Alabama that I'm glad I got to visit. I did not know about this mall, even with as many malls as I visit. There are still some that slip through the cracks, and thanks to the Jasper Mall documentary itself, I found out about this property, and a couple months ago when I was down in Alabama, had to make it a must-stop. So like I said, check that out on Netflix. It's a great story, and just kind of tells really the story that we've been telling for the past 5 years. So that's really it. There is not much to see of this mall. It's a very small rural mall, but given the notoriety of the Netflix series, I did want to check it out. And of course, the aesthetics here are pretty great. I talked to several people in this mall, and they're very proud of this mall, even though it is a dead mall, and people see these titles called dead malls. The only real reason to call them a dead mall is to really draw the attention. That's what the YouTube algorithm likes. So this mall is definitely struggling. It's definitely hurting, and with an owner like Mike Cohan, or whatever his real name may be, the future is obviously not looking good for this place. So, but the people that live here are very proud of it, and you know, the people who do have the stores do the best to keep them up. And of course, I wish that them, you know, I wish them nothing but the best in success. So that's gonna do it. Enjoy the rest of the video, a short one here. I'll be back in 2 weeks with more content. This is Anthony with Aces Adventures. Be sure to follow me on Instagram at AcesAdventures1. Please consider becoming a Patreon donor at patreon.com/AcesAdventures. And one last thing, please, 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 if you are listening to the sound of my voice at this very moment, please do me a favor and click on the bell notification next to the subscribe button so you will get notifications when I put out new videos every other week at 9 p.m. Eastern Time right here on the YouTube channel. Guys, enjoy your weekend, and I'll be back soon with more mall content.